So let's go ahead and look into the first one. And the first one is a hydrohalogenation of an alkyne. Now, a hydrohalogenation, remember, is just an HX with a triple bond, okay? Well, if I were to react that one time, I would expect to get a Markovnikov halogen, okay, added. But it turns out that if you react this twice with alkynes, what you're going to wind up getting is actually gem dihalides. Okay? Now remember that the word gem is stands for geminal, and that means that they're both on the same carbon. Okay? So let's go ahead and see how this works. If I were to react this with one equivalent, I would expect to get that the triple bond attacks the H, kicks out the X, so I wind up getting a carbocation that looks like this, with a positive charge here and an H here. Okay? And then that positive charge would grab, or I'm sorry, the X would grab the positive charge, and I would get my intermediate, my first product, okay? But if I expose it to more than one equivalent, for example, let's say that I exposed it to two equivalents total, then it could react again. So then I would get this double bond attacking the H, kicking out the X. What I would wind up getting is a carbocation that now looks like this, where my X is there, my H is there. And once again, I would get my X, and now by the way, there's two H's there. And now my X would attack there again. So what I would wind up getting is a product that looks like this, where I have a five-membered ring with two X's in the Markovnikov position. Okay, so it's the geminal dihalide part, and that's the Markovnikov part. And then I would have two H's that came from my addition reaction. Okay? And now if you're wondering, well, what about that carbon, shouldn't it have three H's? Shouldn't it be CH3? Yeah, well, that H was always there though, and that kind of looks messy. I'm just going to redraw that. That H was always there because that's the H that was originally on that triple bond anyway. I'm just saying that through this reaction, we wind up adding H twice and X twice. Does that make sense? I hope so. I hope that that flows. It's really not a complicated reaction as long as you know what hydrohalogenation is, okay?